From dairy to grain, cattle ranchers to your own backyard veggie patch, farming provides humans the food we need to survive. But of course, farms also come in all shapes and sizes. Today, we're going big, seriously big, to farms that are the size of entire countries. Today, we're talking about some of the world's largest farms. But before we get into this video, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss anything we post. The countdown begins in Queensland, Australia. Number 10, Marion Downs. This cattle station is run in conjunction with Herbert Downs Outstation, and together they occupy a whopping 3,079,040 acres. It has loads of history. It was established in 1877, and to this day, it is run as a working cattle farm. It is so big that the landscape changes drastically from one border to the other. If you owned this farm, you could go from floodplains on one side to desert country on the other without ever leaving your land. Number 9, Wave Hill. This farm is on the Northern Territory of Australia. It is about 3,335,680 acres big. It's still working as a cattle station. Traditionally, the land was owned by the Gurindji people, but was later explored by Europeans, and the station was established in 1883. This set the stage for the Wave Hill walk-off many years later, which is the thing the station became most known for. 200 Gurindji stockmen and house servants and all of their families initiated this walk-off and strike in August 1966. They held firm all the way to 1975 when a deal was struck at last to give them some of their land back. Number 8 is Inaminka. Another cattle station, this one is in South Australia. It is around 3,706,880 acres in size. The name comes from two Aboriginal words that mean your shelter and your home. Definitely home to the people who lived there, but it was not always easy. Seriously, if you look at the history of this farm, it seems like there's always too much or too little water involved. As big as it is, floods and droughts have put this farm through some very tough times. In 1906, for example, the homestead washed away during the floods. In 1914 and 1916, it was in such a severe drought that over 10,000 cattle died during this time. Yet it has survived it all and still remains a working cattle farm to this day. It shows the strength of the land and the farmer. Home Valley Station is number 7 on our countdown. This Western Australia cattle station covers around 3,459,475 acres. The cattle station has made way for a tourist attraction. For people who wish to have their own outback adventure, this seems like a fun place to go. Parts of the movie Australia were filmed here too, so it does seem that they have moved away from being just like any other cattle stations. Number 6, Davenport Downs, the largest cattle station in Queensland. This property takes up a massive 3,732,200 acres. They only have 10 staff members working there, which is amazing to me. All that land and only 10 people working there? Don't you agree that sounds wild? This farm has had some interesting moments during its lifetime. In 1930, the body of a German man was found on the property. The theory is that he died of dehydration. Then in 1992, the station became infested with feral rats. There were colonies of wild bilbies in the area that was in danger from the cats and needed to be protected. So the environment minister at the time decided to send out an army sharpshooter to reduce the population of feral cats. In just 3 days, he culled around 500 cats. One of them weighed 18 pounds. That is one huge kitty. Meow. This cattle station is about 3,982,080 acres and was established before 1877. It is still mainly used for cattle herding, but they also harvest a large amount of hay on the farm. Just like some of the other farms on this list, it's not only very, very big, but it also has an interesting and sometimes sordid past. For example, in 1885, there was a station hand killed by Aborigines. They had stolen an axe from his camp and used it to commit the horrifying murder. A search for the murderers was held, but they were never found. Another man named John Corbett was trying to deepen a well at the station in the same year. He was using dynamite to do this, but it exploded before he had finished placing it correctly. This caused him to fall to the bottom of the well, and he later died because of his injuries. The area also has a history and habit of flooding. In 1935, a man who came by plane had to be ferried in a bathtub across the Playford because Alexandria had no boats. I can just imagine that sight, a bathtub being used as a boat. Even as recently as 2012, there were such severe floods that the area was turned into an inland sea. In 1955, a huge cattle duffing ring stole cattle from Alexandria and other surrounding stations. After trafficking the animals, the thieves were caught and a special court was set up in Alexandria to hear the charges. What a wild ride this farm has had so far. hard, don't you think? Coming in at number 4 is Clifton Hill Station. The second largest cattle station in the world, Clifton Hill Station comes in around 4,200,960 acres. It is so remote that lots of people who want to visit need to do so by plane. Not only is the land massive, the buildings are too. The infrastructure has a lot to offer. From the central homestead to the airstrips, roadways, and trucking yards, and so much more, there is a lot to see. So when it went up for sale in 2018, for the first time in 60 years, people were curious to see just how much of a pretty penny a piece of land this big would cost you. Sadly, neither the seller nor the buyers ever released the exact price of the sale, but it is estimated that it was somewhere around 45 to 50 million. Definitely a little bit above most of our budgets, I think. Now, for the last three and biggest farms on our list, we are getting into some seriously huge farms. Number 3 on the list is Anna Creek. Anna Creek Station is around 5,850,880 acres. That is bigger than Israel. At first, Anna Creek focused on sheep farming, but they lost so many due to dingo attacks that they changed it to a cattle farm. Even today, life on Anna Creek and other big cattle stations are very remote. Because of their size, the nearest humans could be a day's drive or more away. So most of these homesteads need to be able to function almost like their own small towns. Anna Creek gets television and internet from satellite connections even now. The Cooper Petty Udnadatta one-day mail run is a four-wheel drive mail service which works in the outback of South Australia. Twice a week, they deliver mail to Anna Creek Station, and they can also bring a small amount of cargo. Because it has always needed to function like a small town, Anna Creek has some very old ruins on the site. The Peak ruins are listed on the South Australian Heritage Register. These buildings include things like a cemetery and an old telegraph office. So much history for just one farm. Number 2 on the list is much more modern and twice the size. It is China Modern Dairy. This dairy farm was established in 2005. The farm is divided into 26 smaller farms, but as a whole, it takes up close to 10,999,680 acres, and it is growing. They have plans to build more. One of the independent magazines in China, the China Entrepreneur, rated the company as the fastest growing company in China. At the last count, they kept around 230,000 dairy cows and produced around 3,300 tons of raw milk each day. That just blows my mind. A large part of their land area is used to grow foraging areas. Each section of the production process is kept under surveillance. I'm guessing that takes quite a bit of cameras. They claim to have the safest and highest quality milk in all of China. They do for sure have one of the biggest, but shockingly, it is not the biggest farm in China. That title goes to the largest farm in the world and the number one farm on our list, Mudanjiang City Mega Farm. This farm is massive. It makes the other farms on our list look like backyard veggie patches. At more than 22,499,840 acres, it is the biggest farm in the world by far. In 2015, when Russia banned the use of milk products from the EU, this farm stepped in to fill the need in the market. The size of this farm and the amount it produces is just wild to me. They produce more than 211 million gallons of milk each year. Instead of allowing the cows to graze outside, they keep them inside barns. They make sure that the barns are ventilated enough, and they change the sand bedding twice each day to make sure that the cows are comfortable. Then the cows are milked 3 times a day. Not only do they supply Russia, but it also seems that there's been a huge increase in dairy intake among the Chinese people in recent years. So demand will keep increasing on these huge dairy farms to keep supply up. And judging by the size, I am sure they are up for the challenge. It's really amazing that farms of this size can have enough land and have created some interesting history. From murders to bathtub boats and everything in between, one thing is certain, it takes a lot of work to keep up with farms of these immense sizes. I hope you enjoyed hearing about the world's largest farms. See you next time.